Welcome to my channel. Yeah, 13th question is very important for all exams in 8th class. So, be concentrated on this question. This question is very big, but in this logic, if you find to do, it is very easy. So, what is the question? There are 180 multiple choice questions. Okay, 180 multiple choice questions. Right, next. A candidate gets 4 marks for 1 correct answer. If not attempted or wrongly attempted, that 1 mark is deducted, means subtracting from the total marks. Next, if a candidate scores, how much he scored? 450 marks he scored in the test. How many questions did he answer correctly? So, here how many questions attempted, not given, correctly attempted or unattempted? Are wrongly attempted, not given. So, first of all, we have to assume how many he written correctly, how many wrongly written. We have to assume the number of questions. So, let us assume, let number of questions attempted correctly is equals to x. If correctly x questions attempted, then remaining questions only no incorrectly attempted. So we can find next the number of questions attempted wrongly or unattempted, that can be subtracted from the total questions. It will give the wrongly attempted questions. Score for x questions attempted correctly is equals to 4 into x is equals to 4x. Score for x questions. If one question attempted, 1 into 4. 2 questions attempted, 2 into 4. X questions attempted, 4 into x. That is nothing but 4x. Similarly, here, if answered wrongly, how many marks deducted? 1 mark is deducted. So, score for 180 minus x questions attempted wrongly so we will multiply with 1. 180 minus x into 1 is equals to 180 minus x. So, it is score got for writing correct answers. This is the score for the incorrect answers or unattempted questions. So, total score what given here? Total score is 450. So, how do we get total score? These two scores difference. These two scores difference is nothing but 450. According to problem, according to problem, 4x minus 180 minus x is equals to 450. Now 4x minus into plus minus 180 minus into minus plus x is equals to 450. Now here minus 180 transpose to right hand side, 4x plus x 5x is equals to 450 plus 180. So 5x is equals to 0 plus 0 0, 5 plus 8 13, carry 1, 4 plus 1 5 plus 1 630. So 630 by 5, what we will get? 5 ones are 5 more 1 left, 1 3, 5 twos are 10. Here 3 left, 5, 6 are. So, x is equals to 126. 126 questions attempted correctly. 14th question also look like 13th question. Here total number of notes given, but 5 rupee notes how many, 10 rupee notes how many, don't know. So let us assume rupee 5 notes as x. Solution: number of rupee 5 notes is equals to x. Remaining notes, subtract this from 90, we will get remaining. What the remaining? The number of rupee 10 notes is equals to 90 minus x. Value of rupees 5 notes is equals to x into rupee 5. So is equals to nothing but rupees 5x. Value of rupee 10 notes is equals to 90 minus x into rupees 10. So we will multiply with rupees 10. This will be rupees 900 minus, yeah, 10 into 90, 900 minus 10x. So this will be the total rupees of 10 rupee notes. Now according to our total value, how much? Rupees 500. So this total sum is 500. That is our clue. So total money according to the question is rupees 500. Yeah, total money according to problem, 5 rupee notes and 10 rupees notes only. Now the 10 rupee notes value is this, 5 rupee notes value is this. So let us add this. 5x plus 900 minus 10x is equals to, finally we will get 500. So equating this, we will get the answer. 5x minus 10x. So minus 5x plus 900 is equals to 500. Here plus 900 transfers. Minus 5x is equals to 500 minus 900. Here minus 5x is equals to 500 minus 900 minus 400. Now here x, here 5 transpose to right hand side, minus 400 by minus 5. 5 8s are 40. So 80 times it will go. Now x is equals to 80. We want 90 minus x. So substitute x here. 90 minus x is equals to 90 minus 80 is equals to 10. Number of rupee 5 notes is equals to nothing but 80. Next, number of 10 rupee notes. Number of rupees 10 notes is equals to 10. This question also related to 14th question. So here 14th question, how we done? In that way only we will do here. So total number of things how many? 108. And what are they? Some pens are there, some pencils are there. Here pen each is rupees 7, pencil each is rupees 3. Total things are 108. Total value how much he spent? 564. So let us start the solution. First of all, what we have to assume? Number of pencils or number of pens. Number of pens is equals to x. Then the number of pencils is equals to 108 minus x. So what will be the next? We assumed the number of pens, but the value. Suppose we purchased one pen, two pen, three pens. For that, how much you spent? The value we have to find now. So value of x pens. Suppose one pen I purchased. 1 into 7. 2 pens I purchased. 2 into 7. Here x pens I purchased. X into 7. So it becomes 7x rupees. So next value of 108. 108 minus x. What are these pencils? 108 minus x pencils equals to 108 minus x into here each pencil cost how much? 3. If I purchase 2 pencils, the cost is 6. If I purchase 3 pencils, 3 into 3. If I purchase 4 pencils, 4 into 3. Like that, 108 minus x pencils I purchased. What should they do? It should be multiplied by 3, right? So 3 into 108, 3 8s are 24, 3 1s are 3 minus x. According to this question, how much he spent? 564. So total value how much? This 564 rupees. So these two things value only sum will give us 564. So add these two. 7x plus 324 minus x is equals to 564. Now 7x minus x, 6x plus 324 is equals to 564. Now 6x this side and 324 transpose to other side. 564 minus 324. 6x is equals to 240. 6x is equals to 240. Now x here only 6 transpose to other side. 240 by 6. Here cancel. X is equals to 40. Here how many each type did he buy? So the number of pencils and pens we want. Number of pens x we got here. And next we will find the number of pencils. 108 minus x is equals to 108 minus 40 is nothing but 68. So with this we completed our problem. Now we will write how many type. Number of pens is equals to x. So number of pens is equals to x. What is x here? 40. Next, number of pencils. Number of pencils. How many number of pencils? 100 minus x. Here we done here. This is the number. So 68. With this, the problem is completed. This is very simple question. So the volleyball court is in a rectangular format. Right? So we will find the dimensions from the clues. What we have to find? What is length? What is breadth? We have to assume according to the condition and the perimeter also given. From the perimeter formula, we will derive the length and breadth. So let us go for the solution. What is our length? Length is twice the width. So the width is nothing but breadth only now. So breadth, let breadth is equals to x. Then what is the length? Length is twice. Twice means what? Two times x, right? 2x. So what is the perimeter? Your perimeter is equals to 2 into L plus B. So what is L here? 2x. Plus what is B? X. 2 into 2x plus x. 3x is equals to 177. 2 3s are 6x is equals to 177. X is equals to 177. We will get x is equals to 29.5 feet. Here what is x breadth? So we got the breadth as x. Breadth is equals to x. That is equals to 29.5 feet. Next, what is our length? X means 2 into 29.5 feet. 59 feet. 2 into 29.5 feet is equal to 59 feet. 12th question is very easy. Ages of Rahul and Lakshmi are in ratio 5:7. And 4 years later, the ages sum will be 56 years. So, first of all, we will write the solution with starting with the ratio. What is given 5:7? So, ratio of ages of Rahul and Lakshmi Rahul and Lakshmi is equals to 5:7. 5:7. Now we have to find the present ages. So here present ages don't know. Here only ratio is given. So their ages don't know. Let us here understand that 5:7 nothing but that numbers and their ages will be 5 multiples and 7 multiples. And that multiples must be same. If you take 5 multiples means 5 into x. We have to multiply with 7 also because ratio must be in same quantities. So we will take 5x is present age of Rahul and 7x is present age of Lakshmi. So let present age of Rahul is equals to 5 multiples means 5x. Next, so what we have find next? Lakshmi. Present age of Lakshmi is equals to 7x. So we found now means we assumed the present ages of Rahul and Lakshmi. Now according to the condition, what later, how many years later? 4 years later. Later means after 4 years means their ages will increase or decrease. Increase. So here also after 4 years. After 4 years, what will happen? Here Rahul and Lakshmi, both ages will increase or decrease? Increase. So age of Rahul is equals to 5x plus 4. Next, age of Lakshmi also increased by 4. So after 4 years, what their ages sum will be? 56. So we will add these two and we will get 56. That is the condition. So sum of their ages, how much? 56 years. When it is? Now after 4 years only, this is total condition. So sum of their ages nothing but these two we will add here. 5x plus 4 plus 7x plus 4 is equals to 56. Now 5x plus 7x, 12x plus 4 plus 4, 8 is equals to 56. Here 12x equals to 8 transpose to right hand side, 56 minus 8, 12x is equals to 48. Now 12x is equals to 48. Now solve x. X is equals to 48 by 12 on the 12 fours are. X is equals to 4. So take 5x and 5x nothing but 5 into x. So what is x here? X is equals to 4. So 5x is equals to 20. Now we will find 7x. 7x is equals to 7 into 4. 28. So 20 and 28 are their present ages. Whose present ages? Rahul and Lakshmi. So what we can write? Present ages of Rahul and Lakshmi are 20 and 28 years. So this is the last question in this exercise. This is very very easy. Here we have book. In this x, this will be x plus 1 the page number. So sum of these two numbers is what? 373. Here 2x plus 1 is equals to 373. 2x here 1 transpose to other side. 373 minus 1. So 2x equals to 372. X is equals to here 372 by 2. So what will be answer? 2 1s are 2 8s are 2 6s are 186. Then what is x plus 1? X plus 1 is equals to 187. So these two are the page numbers required for the sum, which is 373.
Finally friends, idi mana video nachinda. So nachite ee video ni like cheyandi. Friends, ee video mana vallaku use avutund anukunte tappakunda mana video ni share cheyandi. మన ఛానల్ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయనట్లయితే ఛానల్లో ఉన్న వీడియోస్ని ఒక్కసారి గమనించండి. ఫ్రెండ్స్ ఇఫ్ నచ్చాయనుకుంటే ఛానల్ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసి పక్కనే ఉన్న బెల్ ఐకాన్ని క్లిక్ చేయండి. మరొక ఇంట్రెస్టింగ్ వీడియోతో మీ ముందుకు వస్తాను. టేక్ కేర్. థ్యాంక్ యూ.